Hello everybody and welcome back to my YouTube channel, that is Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. And today we are going to talk about a very important topic from examination point of view, which is also a very interesting topic, that is cancer. So each and every cell has some rules to divide, and the three major rules for every cell division is Parampara, Pratishtha or Anushasan. So the cells which do not follow these three things are known as cancerous cell. It means that if any kind of cell division is uncontrolled in nature, okay, if a cell is not dividing in a way, or it is, you know, dividing in an uncontrollable manner, it is not following the rules of controlled cell division, then that particular cell is going to be the cancerous cell, or it will form some sort of tumors in our body. Cancer is one of the most dreadful disease in case of human beings as well as in case of other animals. और काफी ज्यादा खतरनाक ये डिजीज मानी जाती है, बिकॉज एवरी ईयर इन इंडिया वी विल टॉक अबाउट ह्यूमन बीइंग्स, देन मिलियन ऑफ पीपल गेट अफेक्टेड विद कैंसर एंड मोस्ट ऑफ देम डाई बिकॉज वी डू नॉट हैव अ प्रॉपर इक्विपमेंट फॉर द करेक्ट डायग्नोसिस एट अर्ली स्टेज एज वेल एज यू नो करेक्ट ट्रीटमेंट. तो हम काफी सारे कैंसर पेशेंट्स को बचा लेते हैं विद द रिमूवल ऑफ दैट ट्यूमर सेल्स, लेकिन काफी सारे केसेस ऐसे होते हैं जिनमें डेथ हो जाती है. So the cancer research is one of the most vital areas in case of biological sciences research, where we can learn the ways, or we can research on the ways to diagnose cancer easily as well as to treat it with a perfect way, treat the cancer in a perfect way so that more people would not die of cancer, right? So now we will be studying in this particular video about basic terminologies. There are some terms which are very important to understand cancer. And in the next video, we will be talking about the ways to diagnose cancer as well as some of the treatments which can be done to cure cancer. Okay, so the first point is contact inhibition. This is the property of normal cells. For example, this is the normal cell. This is the normal cell. It is going to be expand, right? This is the property of a particular cell that it will enlarge in size and then it will divide to maintain the nuclear and cytoplasmic ratio. We have already talked about it in cell cycle and cell division chapter. और उसके बाद ये chapter पढ़ना क्यों जरूरी है? क्योंकि in cell cycle and cell division chapter we have talked about the regular manner in which cell division takes place. That is the regulated and controlled manner of cell division. But in case of cancer cell, it is uncontrolled proliferation of cell or the uncontrolled division of cell, and it can only be understood when we know the mechanism of controlled cell division. अगर कंट्रोल्ड सेल डिवीजन समझ में आएगा तभी तो अनकंट्रोल्ड सेल डिवीजन पढ़ेंगे. इसीलिए इस चैप्टर को पढ़ने से पहले सेल साइकिल एंड सेल डिवीजन पढ़ना बहुत ज्यादा जरूरी हो जाता है. एंड वी नो वेरी वेल अबाउट द होल चैप्टर एंड वी नो वेरी वेल अबाउट द प्रोसेसेस ऑफ नॉर्मल सेल डिवीजन. इन दिस पर्टिकुलर केस द सेल्स और द ट्यूमर सेल्स द कैंसर सेल्स विल नॉट फॉलो द नॉर्मल रूल्स ऑफ सेल डिवीजन एंड दे विल डिवाइड इन सच अ वे दैट दे आर अनकंट्रोल्ड. ओके, दे विल फॉर्म मेनी ऑफ सेल्स. They will form a bundle of cells, right? Or they aggregate in the form of a bunch that is usually known as tumor. Okay, this is a very important term, that is tumor. Okay, और वही tumor आगे चलते cancer बनाता है. Okay, but not all cancers are tumors. Okay, cancer में tumor होता है, लेकिन हर cancer में tumor नहीं होता. For example, blood cancer में tumors नहीं बनते. So, ऐसा जरूरी नहीं है कि जहां कैंसर हो वहां ट्यूमर हो. नॉट ऑल कैंसर आर ट्यूमरस, राइट? बिकॉज इन केस ऑफ ब्लड कैंसर देयर इज नो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ट्यूमर्स. ओके, सो देयर विल बी सम एक्सेप्शंस इन दैट केस. तो यहां पर बात करते हैं फिलहाल कॉन्टैक्ट इनहिबिशन की. फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई एम अ सेल, ओके, एंड आई स्टार्ट ग्रोइंग. तो मैं जब ग्रो कर रहा हूं मेरे बगल में कोई सेल है, देयर इज अ सेल एडजेसेंट टू मी एंड इट हैज ऑल्सो स्टार्ट ग्रोइंग. सो व्हेन वी हैव ग्रोन इनफ देन आवर वॉल्स वुड बी कनेक्टिंग विद ईच अदर. Okay, for example, this is the cell, it has grown enough. Now these two cells will be in contact because they have, you know, grown in enough manner. Now they are large enough to get in contact with each other and they will show some signals. Okay, ki ab bahut ho chuka, now you cannot grow further. So this particular contact will show some inhibitory signal which will inhibit the growth further. Okay, जब ये दोनों आके आपस में टकरा जाएंगे, when there is contact between two growing cells, then there would be no further growth of these cells. This particular thing is known as contact inhibition, and this is very necessary in case of normal cells. Okay, this is about normal cells, but in case of cancerous cell, there is no contact inhibition, there is no signal that you have grown enough, now you have to divide. So they keep on growing, they will keep on dividing, keep on growing, keep on dividing, because of lack of contact inhibition. There are no inhibitory signals generated when two cells, two growth cells are in contact with each other. That's why they divide in such a manner that they are uncontrolled. They will form millions of cells, okay, by dividing further and further and further. So there is no contact inhibition, therefore the division is uncontrolled, and therefore tumors are formed, which are the aggregation of cells. Okay, जो एक बॉडी में जमा हो जाएंगे, they will aggregate on a particular part, on a particular organ of human body, and they will secrete some kind of things which are, you know, suppressing our systems. So इसीलिए वो क्या करते हैं, हमारी बॉडी में कैंसर को बढ़ा देते हैं, कैंसर पैदा कर देते हैं. Now, the tumors that we are talking about, that is the aggregation of cells. There are many cells which are formed about division of single tumor cells. और वो आगे जाके कैंसर सेल से डिवाइड होने के बाद जो मिलियंस ऑफ सेल बने हैं वो एग्रीगेट हो जाते हैं, एंड दे फॉर्म अ बंच. दैट पर्टिकुलर बंच इज नोन एज ट्यूमर, एंड दैट ट्यूमर इज ऑफ टू मेजर टाइप्स व्हिच आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, एंड द डिफरेंसेस आर आस्क्ड इन बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशन. सो बोर्ड एग्जाम के लिए सबसे ज्यादा जरूरी है कि आप ट्यूमर में डिफरेंस बताएं. सो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन बेनाइन ट्यूमर एंड मैलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर, दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम बोर्ड्स व्यू. As well as malignant tumor की जो properties हैं, these are important from NEET and AIIMS point of view. So you have to focus on this particular topic. So now in case of benign tumor, it is confined to a particular place. This is the very important property that it would not spread. Okay? For example, this is the place where there is tumor. Okay? For example, let's say this is the place. यहाँ पर ट्यूमर है, इट विल स्टे ऑन दिस प्लेस ओनली, इट विल नॉट स्प्रेड लाइक दिस, इट विल नॉट गो टू फर्दर प्लेसेस, राइट, देयर इज नो प्रोसेस लाइक दिस, इट विल कंफाइंड टू दैट पर्टिकुलर प्लेस ओनली. जिस जगह पे बना है उसी जगह पर रहेगा, आजू बाजू कहीं नहीं जाएगा, बॉडी में कहीं भी दूसरे ऑर्गन्स में इन्वेड नहीं करेगा. देयर इज नो इन्वेजन, देयर इज नो मेटास्टेसिस, एज वेल एज देयर इज नो स्प्रेडिंग. ओके, सो इट विल बी कन्फाइंड टू दैट पर्टिकुलर प्लेस where it is formed. Okay, that's about benign tumor. Now it comes to malignant tumor. Agar baat kare malignant tumor ki, so it is a mass of neoplastic cells. What are neoplastic cells? Neoplastic cells are also known as cancerous cells or tumor cells. So the tumor cells which we are talking about, it is a mass of those cells. Okay, since we are talking about tumor, and tumor is the aggregation of cells, so obviously there are many neoplastic cells or many cancerous cells or many tumor cells which are aggregated in a particular manner to form a malignant tumor. Now this particular thing show invasion. Now what is invasion? It simply means that it get invaded into different kind of organs. ये काफी सारे organs के अंदर घुसने की कोशिश करता है. Okay? It has a tendency to go inside different kind of organs to be spreaded. Okay, it start dividing wherever it will go. For example, let's talk about a random case. For example, this is a malignant tumor. Now it has reached to this particular organ. For example, this is stomach. Now it will start dividing in stomach. The second part has gone to liver. So it will start dividing in liver. Okay, so the place where it will go, it will start dividing on that place. This is known as invasion. Okay, invasion means it is going to different kind of places. This is invasion. Okay, and it will proliferate or it will divide on the places or the organs where it will go. So invasion का मतलब है कि एक particular malignant जो tumor है, उसके cells काफी organs में जाने की कोशिश करते हैं. That is invasion. After invasion, the tumor cells will start proliferating or dividing in those particular organs where they are now. So they will start proliferating in these kind of organs. It means that the tumor has spread it. But in case of benign tumor, it is confined to a particular place. It is not getting spread it. It is not getting much proliferated. Therefore, they are a little bit safe. But in case of malignant tumor, they are not safe because they are showing invasion. This is very important. And the first property, they are showing invasion. And the second one, they are getting proliferated at the place of invasion. For example, if a tumor cell goes to stomach, it will proliferate on stomach. It will divide on stomach and it will form many tumor cells in the stomach itself. This is the property of malignant tumor, which makes it much more different and much more deadly as compared to the benign tumor. Okay, now the next property is that it makes other cells starve because these cells are continuously dividing, right? Since benign tumor is not showing invasion as well as it is not proliferating in that much amount, lekin jo malignant tumor hai that are invading, that is dusre organs mein ghus bhi rahe hain, वहां पर जाके डिवाइड भी कर रहे हैं एंड वी नो वेरी वेल दैट द डिवीजन नीड्स एनर्जी. ओके, एक सेल है उसे ग्रोथ के लिए एनर्जी चाहिए और ग्रोथ के बाद ही डिवीजन होता है, राइट, टू मेक इक्वल डॉटर सेल्स. सो वो बाकी सारे सेल से कम्पीट करेंगे. देयर इज अ कॉम्पिटिशन बिटवीन नॉर्मल सेल्स एज वेल एज ट्यूमर सेल्स एंड द ट्यूमर सेल्स विल कम्पीट फॉर डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशनल थिंग्स टू द नॉर्मल सेल्स और नॉर्मल सेल्स से दे विल you know derive nutrition or they will compete for the nutrition with normal cells and they will take nutrition, they will grow and they will divide. Okay, so they have to increase their number, and to increase their number they have to divide, and to divide they have to grow, and to grow they need nutrition, and for that nutrition they will compete with different kind of normal cells that are present on different organs in case of human body. So दे विल कम्पीट विद दो सेल्स, उनके साथ लड़ाई होगी, झगड़ा होगा और एंड में ट्यूमर सेल्स जीत जाएंगे और ऐसे चलते चलते काफी ऑर्गन्स में इन्वेजन होती जाएगी, वहां पर प्रोलिफरेशन होती जाएगी. देयर विल बी अ लॉट ऑफ ट्यूमर सेल्स इन केस ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल. दिस इज द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मैलिग्नेंट ट्यूमर. नंबर वन इन्वेजन, नंबर टू प्रोलिफरेशन, एंड नंबर थ्री दे विल स्टार्व अदर सेल. इट सिंपली मीन्स दैट स्टार्व का मतलब होता है फास्ट रखना या फिर भूखा रहना. ओके, तो भूखा रहने का क्या मतलब है? That it would not let normal cells to eat, okay? Because they will derive nutrition from the nutrition thing that we have taken. So वो normal cells के जाने से पहले tumor cells के पास चली जाएगी. Because there is a kind of competition between tumor cells and normal cells. This is very important. And they will show metastasis. Metastasis is one of the most important property, and I have marked M and M over here because the most important property of malignant tumor is metastasis. Metastasis simply means that it will invade as well as it will proliferate. So there are two main properties, that are invasion and proliferation, and that proliferation is known as metastasis. Yani ki baaki sare organs mein jayenge aur baaki sare organs mein jaake divide karenge, apna number badhayenge, kaafi sare tumor cells banayenge. This is the property of malignant tumor, as well as they will not let normal cells to eat well. That's why they will show competition. Okay, this is very important. So these are the some properties or some kind of differences between tumors. We have learned about the basics that cancer sciences is getting evolved and it is going to be the most important branches of biological sciences research. Or there is a process in normal cells that are contact inhibition, which is not found in cancerous cell because they do not follow the normal rules and regulations of cell division. They show uncontrolled proliferation or uncontrolled cell division. Okay, that's why they increase in number so large. They will form a bunch of cells that is known as tumor. That tumor is of two type, that is benign tumor, which is confined to a particular place. There is malignant tumor, which spread itself, that is invasion, and it will proliferate at that particular place jahan par wo pahuncha hai, that is known as metastasis, and it will not let the normal cells eat well. Therefore, वो क्या करेगा? खाना लेगा. कहां से लेगा? कॉम्पिटिशन करके. किससे कॉम्पिटिशन करेगा? नॉर्मल सेल्स के साथ. सो जो ट्यूमर सेल है हमेशा नॉर्मल सेल्स के साथ कॉम्पिटिशन करेंगे और उसके बाद गड़बड़ी हो जाएगी कि हमारी बॉडी में काफी सारे ऐसे प्रोसेसेस हैं जो कि रुक जाए. ओके, सो नाउ देयर आर सम सॉर्ट ऑफ कैंसर कॉजिंग एजेंट्स. ओके, काफी सारी चीजें हैं जो कैंसर कॉज करती हैं इन केस ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स. दैट कैंसर कॉजिंग थिंग्स आर नोन एज कार्सिनोजेंस. कार्सिनो सिंपली मीन्स कैंसर. दिस पर्टिकुलर वर्ड कार्सिनो सिंपली मीन्स कैंसर एंड जन मीन्स जनरेशन. इट मीन्स दैट दीज आर कैंसर जनरेटिंग और कैंसर फॉर्मिंग एजेंट्स. दोस कार्सिनोजेंस या फिर कैंसर को बनाने वाली जो चीजें हैं, दे कैन बी बायोलॉजिकल, दे कैन बी फिजिकल एज वेल एज दे कैन बी केमिकल. फिजिकल मीन्स दे कैन बी डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ रेडिएशन. ओके, केमिकल मीन दे कैन बी टोबैको, दे कैन बी स्मोकिंग एंड डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ केमिकल एजेंट्स जो कि हमारी बॉडी में जब एंटर करते हैं तो हमारी नॉर्मल सेल डिवीजन को चेंज कर देते हैं. दे विल टोटली चेंज द प्रोसेस ऑफ सेल डिवीजन एंड दे विल मेक अ पर्टिकुलर नॉर्मल सेल इनटू कैंसरस सेल. एज वेल एज सम सॉर्ट ऑफ बायोलॉजिकल एजेंट्स. देयर आर सम बायोलॉजिकल एजेंट्स व्हिच विल make a normal cell into a neoplastic cell or a cancer cell or a tumor cell, which will definitely cause cancer in case of human beings. So let's study about different kind of carcinogens. So the carcinogens may be physical agents, they may be chemical agents, as well as they can be biological agents. So physical agents, it is very important to know the radiations. So they can be ionizing radiation, they can be non-ionizing radiation. There is G, simply means there is gamma rays or X rays. So X or gamma rays, jo hai, ye kya karte hai? These are ionizing. Okay? So these ionizing rays, yani ki X or gamma rays, ye karte hai hamari body mein mutations, and those mutations will lead to cancer formation. If the wave is non-ionizing, for example UV radiation, then that radiation may also cause different kind of things. For example, thymine dimer is formed. We know very well that adenine pairs to thymine with help of double hydrogen bond, but in some cases there is thymine dimer formed, and that thymine dimer is a very important mutation which is corrected by DNA repair mechanisms. Isko correct karne ke liye mechanism to hai, lekin ye kisse cause hoti hai? UV radiation se. So there are some sort of radiations which are non-ionizing in nature, probably the UV radiation, which causes mutation in case of our DNA, that will lead to different kind of abnormalities, probably cancer. Okay, so kaafi sari abnormalities hoti hai, and you will learn all these kind of things in your graduation in very much detail. Abhi aapki itni zyada detail nahi hai, it is a very important topic and very interesting topic, kyunki hum ye graduation mein padh chuke hain and it is very pleasurable to learn. So aage chalke dekhenge hum log, lekin ab yahan par physical agents ki agar baat kare, so there are different kind of radiations. They may be ionizing, yani ki ho sakte hain gamma rays or x-rays. They may be non-ionizing, that is UV rays. Aap log aise yaad kar sakte hain, ionizing mein there is single alphabet, and in G and X there is also single alphabet, but in case of non-ionizing there are two alphabets, N and I, and in UV there is also two alphabets, so UV is non-ionizing. So you can learn in that way. These are the important physical agents that causes cancer or which makes normal cell to be converted into neoplastic cell. When we talk about different kind of agents, which are for example smoke and tobacco, so it is very well written on the smoke and tobacco packets or cigarette packets that tobacco and cigarette causes cancer. That's why these also causes cancer. There is smoking and there are different kind of habits such as tobacco. Okay, they also causes cancer. There are some viruses which also affect. These are biological agents, obviously viruses are biological agents. So those viral oncogens are very important. So jo viral oncogens hai, these are some viruses which causes cancer. Okay, so these are biological agents which are viral oncogens, as well as there are some kind of cellular oncogens also, which are abbreviated as C oncogens. So there are proto-oncogens or cellular oncogens. Why these are known as proto-oncogens? Oncogen simply means cancer generating cells, and proto simply means that they are in pro stage. Okay, they will further modify themselves to become an oncogen. So normal jo cells they, these are proto-oncogens, but due to some kind of biological abnormalities, okay, these cellular oncogens or those proto-oncogens or normal cells will get converted into cancerous cell, tumor cells और neoplastic cell, okay? So जो proto oncogens है, ये oncogen बनने से पहली stage है, this is primary stage. So proto oncogen it is safe, लेकिन oncogen बनने के बाद it is fully matured cancer causing cell, okay? It will behave like cancer causing cell or neoplastic cell or tumor cell. So the proto oncogens or the cellular oncogens will make a tumor cell when some kind of biological abnormality is there, or when some kind of atmosphere is there. There are many kind of factors affecting normal cells. Okay, jab unhe kuch aise situation milegi, whenever there is a situation which is not well for normal cell division, to kya karenge, kuch abnormalities aa jati hain, and due to that they have started uncontrolled division, or us uncontrolled division ko obviously hum bolenge tumor formation or cancer. So there are different kind of agents such as physical agents jo ki honge radiations. They may be ionizing radiations such as gamma rays and x-rays. They may be non-ionizing radiations such as UV rays. The cancer is caused with the help of tobacco as well as smoking habits. as well as there will be different kind of viral oncogens. Those viruses will, you know, insert some sort of things in our body which will create some abnormalities, as well as kuch cellular oncogens or proto oncogens hote hain body mein, which when stimulated with help of different kind of environmental factors ya fir body ke internal factors, jab unhe koi aisi condition milegi which is suitable for uncontrolled proliferation, then they will proliferate or divide uncontrollably, which is known as cancer. So this is a basic lecture about different kind of terminology, the differences between different tumor cells, as well as the causes of cancer. In the very next lecture, we are going to talk about how we can diagnose cancer and what are the different treatments which can be done when someone suffers from cancer. So I hope that this video is beneficial for you. Agar aapko ye video pasand aaye, then please do hit like button. And if you are watching my video for the very first time and you found it beneficial, then please do share it with your friends, as well as subscribe to my channel very soon. Thank you so much.